Hello friends, welcome to the Netherlands. Today we have something exciting to show you. Mike, what news do you have for us?
Well, the news is attached to my K3. It's the new 1650 DS Star lens. I've been using this beauty for a few weeks now and I really came to love it, and we're here today to talk about it.
And we're not just going to talk about it, of course we're going to take you with us throughout several locations here in the Netherlands, and we're going to take a look what this beautiful lens can do. So let's go.
When I'm adding lenses to my kit, apart from optical qualities, things I pay attention to are weather sealing. The 1650 has got all weather sealing, which means it's top of the line. Apart from that, the barrel is full metal, which means it can withstand a hump and a bump here and there. And most importantly, it's a fixed aperture of f2.8, which means that during zooming, my exposure stays constant. So I've always got the right exposure on my images. Although I'm not a technician, I do want to talk slightly about the lens design and mainly the autofocusing part. What the engineers did is they reduced the autofocusing group in size and they incorporated the PLM motor. And that combination together makes sure that autofocus is much faster and also more responsive. So a big improvement just by redesigning that lens group. Yeah, with situations like this, what you see behind me, you see a big tree, small leaves, bright sky behind it. So normally a situation where the not so good lenses have some chromatic aberration. So I always check if I'm happy with what I'm seeing. And with this combination, I'm very, very happy with what I'm seeing. The chromatic aberration situations like this is very well controlled.
So Mike, you've been using this lens and camera combination for a couple of weeks. This is my first time using it. What are your first impressions?
Well, always when you receive something that's newly designed, it was new for your camera bag, you have high expectations. And after the first image, the first thing you do is look at your image 100%. And I think, wow. And after that, you go home. You load the shots into your screen, and then at home on the big screen, it's reaffirmed. It really is a wow combination. Not only the center sharpness, but also the corner sharpness of this combination is unlike anything I've seen so far. So I'm very, very happy that Pentax released this lens.
The full name of this lens is the HD Pentax DA Star 16-50 f2.8 ED PLM AW. It's the new generation star lens for Pentax APS-C cameras. It's a big step in quality and usability, and as you can see, Mike is truly happy with how this lens performs. Shooting with it is fun. I don't know how else to say it. 16-50 on a crop sensor body is a range you can use in so many different situations. It's a lens I could see me using for landscape, documentary, portraits, a true workhorse. And in combination with the K3 Mark III, the results are spectacular. We just arrived at our second location. We are in IJmuiden. And when Mike and I were talking about developing this video, Mike told me it would be very beneficial to the video to show several areas. Mike, why was that?
Well, mainly because as a landscape or nature photographer, you don't know what you get. And part of or some of the areas we're visiting today, I visited in previous weeks as well. I use the same combination. So some of the images you're going to see in the video are from today, and some of the images are made previously. But also the reason why I'm choosing different locations, because I want to be surprised as a photographer, and that's where a zoom lens comes in very handy. If I encounter a great scene which is suitable for landscape photography, I zoom in wide. If I want to if I meet an interesting person and want to make his portrait, I zoom into the tail end of the image. If I want to focus on one of the ships here in the harbor further down the road, I also use the tail. So the versatility of the lens really shines when we're using different areas in this video as well. So that's why we're traveling. One of the challenges I gave myself for this video is only to use the editing capabilities that are inside the camera. So I would use the RAW converter and the editing tools that are inside the K3. What you see here is an example of an image I took yesterday. It's the pier of Scheveningen, or close to the pier of Scheveningen. What you will do, you will open the RAW converter. I would see if I need adjustments in white balance. Often a white balance like this can make it a bit colder. In this case, I'm going for daylight color. I like the tone of that one. I always shoot natural, so I might opt for a more landscape look, which I've selected here. After that, when I'm happy, I just press save and I'm writing it to the second card slot. What you got then is this image, and this is a good time also to show you what this lens is capable of. We're going to the center, and this is at 6.7, that's 100% magnification, of course, in the center. Sharpness is excellent. I think I've shot at f8. The background looks good as well, and when we move all the way to the corners, you can see that the stones retain their sharpness. And that is something that I'm really happy with. So from center to the corners, it performs excellent.
And that concludes our second location here in IJmuiden. We are going to walk through the harbor back to the cars, and then we are going to take you to the third and final location of this video. So let's
go. I arrived at Petten, one of my favorite patches at the north of Holland. The beach is down below me, but I've been thinking about a way to show you how the autofocus has improved. What we did, we attached the field monitor, the camera switched to live view. I'm going to focus quickly here on the background to the beach house. Now I'm switching back to Niels, and you see every time I press the autofocus button on the back, it reacts very, very responsive. The other thing that I like about the lens is something we tested earlier on. We made some portraits of Niels, and when you see, when you open up the aperture, you see that the background becomes really nice and creamy. The bokeh of the lens is something that I, as a photography lover, really like as well. Let's go to the beach and continue there.
And that concludes our video about the new Pentax 16-50 2.8. In my opinion, it's a very nice lens. Mike, can you recap for us what this lens means to you?
Yeah, of course. I've been using it now for 2 or 3 weeks. And sometimes you get a product in your hands that really ticks all the boxes. And in this case, my photography boxes. It's got an excellent build quality. It's got weather sealing. It's very sturdy. Most importantly, the image quality is outstanding, not only the center, but through the corners. It's fast, it's responsive. I'm shooting in conditions like this, we were going to shoot later on, but I'm shooting into the light. Chromatic aberration is very well controlled with this lens. The K3 I've been using already for some time with great joy. And in Holland, you've got the saying that 1 and 1 is 3. And in this case, 1 and 1 really is 3.
Mark 3.
Yeah. So no, I'm very, very happy with this result. And I think this lens will do tremendously well within the community.
So we'll just leave it at that. As you can see, the light still is very nice. So we are going to have some more fun using this camera and this lens and just enjoying photography. Thank you guys very much for watching. And we hope to see you soon in the next video.
Definitely. Bye.
Bye.